have a big round of applause, please. The ALB is just going to go back out and get the kayak now. Later on, the ALB will be launching at 2:15.
This is Holyhead Coast Guard paging Llandudno ILB, Llandudno ILB. Multiple reports of kayaker in trouble off Craigadon, Llandudno. Flare has been sighted. Immediate launch ILB. Repeat, immediate launch ILB.
Dr. Barbara Saunderson in the water. This is the third inshore lifeboat which has been very kindly funded by the Saunderson family, great benefactors of the RNLI service here, especially in darkened conditions, knowing that they're going to be safe, they're going to live. There we see the feet in the air of the casualty. Inshore lifeboat speeding to shore. All depending on the circumstance of the casualty, there would be maybe just making his way out of the boathouse, ladies and gentlemen, the brand new all-weather lifeboat, the William F. Yates. Public donations and subscriptions, £2.2 million, the cost of the boat that's coming out of the boathouse now. Since coming on station in 2018, the Shannon class lifeboat been involved in 8 launches. The last launch was on the 27th of July, and it was a yacht in trouble off the Orme. two people on board, so the Willimurphy H was tasked to go and rescue the occupants and the boats. It was taken in tow and was taken to Conway, where the Conway ILB towed the boat into the harbour area. And the Shannon class lifeboat coming out now, top speed of 30 knots, and can make it round the Great Orme from the lifeboat house in 20 minutes to Conway, which is quite something, very much faster than the previous lifeboat, the Andy Pierce. The Shannon class lifeboat is the first modern generation all-weather lifeboat to run on water jets rather than propellers. Now this allows the vessel to operate in shallow waters and to be intentionally beached. Water jets give the coxswain greater control when alongside other watercraft in confined waters and in all sea conditions. Now the water jet's intake is located below the transom and is protected by grills to stop large debris damaging the impellers. But at maximum power, the Shannon class lifeboat pumps 1.5 tonnes of water each second from its water jets. So proud to have the new lifeboat house and the Shannon on service in Llandudno now. Been a long time coming. 20 years the RNLI here in Llandudno have been waiting to have this new boat house and the new lifeboats. 20 long hard years of campaigning and fundraising, and we've seen the results of that 20 years of hard work. Now making its way to the water's edge, which will be launched ahead of the arrival of the rescue helicopter. On the Shannon, there are two 650
stepping goers on the Shannon. The aft deck has a lot of space, giving the crew a good platform for performing casualty evacuations with rescue helicopters, and we'll be witnessing that very shortly. I'm making it easier for the crew to set up tows. The foredeck restraint and launch mechanism allows the coxswain to release the boat from its carriage via the upper steering position. The Shannon has two steering positions, one at the upper steering position, which offers an elevated 360 degrees view, and one at the wheelhouse, which provides shelter in the most challenging of conditions. Casualty care, of course, on shouts is paramount. A comprehensive suite of medical equipment is carried on board, including oxygen and full resuscitation kit, Entonox for pain relief, large responder bags, and three different stretchers. The basket stretcher can be securely mounted on board as well. So if you imagine in a proper lifeboat house situation with the ramp that we all have known over the years, we don't have the ramp here in Llandudno, so the boat will be tilted upwards, rear end up. You'll see the boat being lifted momentarily. Then the coxswain will launch. There we go, going up into the air.
recovery system with what you're seeing there. The tractor and powered carriage system operates as a mobile slipway. Solving the RNLI's unique challenge of transporting, launching and recovering the 18-ton Shannon class over some of the most demanding beaches at lifeboat stations around the country. The carriage mounting cradle rotates the vessel through 180 degrees. We'll be seeing that later, greatly reducing the time between recovery and the vessel being made ready for relaunch. And the shape of the Shannon-class boat's hull is really the most important factor in how she'll handle at sea. During the development of the Shannon-class lifeboat, a number of different hull shapes were trialled. The chosen hull gives the smoothest ride through the roughest seas. Again, just imagine you're lost at sea. You've made that call to the Coast Guard. All funded by public donations and subscriptions. Now, all lifeboats have a unique identification number. You can see it on the front of the William F. Yeats. The first part of the all-weather lifeboat's number indicates the class. All Shannon-class lifeboats beam with 13. Now, because they're just over 13 metres in length, the numerals after the dash refer to the radio and its gun are also integrated in the armrest, while the helm has full control of the steering. Jet buckets and throttles are at the fingertips on the Shannon-class lifeboat. You can see now how maneuverable the William F. Yeats is. Stops very quickly, turning circle, very small, very maneuverable. It's a lot lower in the water than the previous lifeboats, making it that much easier to retrieve casualties from the water in a rescue situation. Now the systems and information management system, known as the SIMS, allows crew members to control the lifeboats and access information from their seats in the wheelhouse. It means they spend less time standing up and moving around the vessel and are therefore less prone to injury, especially in rough weather conditions. And the SIMS provides access to all communications, the HF and the MF radio, the direction finder, the DF, the intercom, the navigation, the radar chart, global positioning systems, that's the GPS, the depth and speed, and machinery monitoring, including engines, transmission, fuel, and the bilge as well. Local control for each workstation is by means of a large trackball with selected buttons. An ink screen is adaptable for operation. If you've never been here when a rescue helicopter has come over, it does make quite a lot of noise. We can see it now just heading towards the pierhead, hanging a left in a moment.
Make
flying low over the bay, waiting for them. Nice big wave to the rescue helicopter, ladies and gentlemen. The Madison Coast Guard. So if you've ever wondered what brings people ashore safely, it's practice, 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 dedication, passion for the cause. Don't forget these guys go out in all weathers, whenever called, 24/7, 365. You'll notice the amount of spray caused with the downdraft of the rescue helicopter. It's apparently, according to the volunteer crews, it's quite something when you're, especially in the all-weather lifeboat, inshore lifeboats, and all that spray is coming up and they're retrieving a casualty into the helicopter. You can't see a thing, almost.
Hi, Coast Guard, flooding on RB, ops normal. Our current position is approximately 1 mile northeast of the boathouse, flooding on North Shore, and we'll be remaining in Flandin Bay for the next 15 minutes, shall we?
Flandin RB, roger, calling it out.
Precision sailing, precision flying. Maintain speed, direction. Currently 6 crew on board the Shannon class. Survivor capacity for the Shannon class lifeboats, for self-righting it's 23, non-self-righting 79 people can go on that boat. 13.6 metres in length, maximum speed 25 knots, the range, the endurance is 250 nautical miles. Engines on the Shannon 2, 13 litre, 650 horsepower, Scania D13 engines, twin Hamilton, HD364 water jets. And in case you're wondering how much fuel is on board the Shannon class, 2,740 litres of fuel. They don't go to Asda for that. You can see the winchman being winch down to almost being in the water. Now the job is to get him on board to William F. Yates. And the casualty I gather will be retrieved from the lifeboat. Quite a wind blowing out in the bay today. The wind forecast at various times of the day in excess of 40 mile an hour winds. The winchmen now just on the rear of the William F. Yates. He's now detached from the rescue helicopter. I suppose in a real life situation, the winchman. Going into the water, I can see the forehead of the elephant. Well known landmark. in the Llandudno. Opportunity. The six crew members of the Shannon, the William F. Yates. Beaching, and you can see some of the training exercises that went on a few years ago, and it's quite amazing. And behind us now, going over the mountains, going back for today, you might like to pay a visit inside the lifeboat house and have a cup of tea, cup of coffee, have the biscuits. There are some souvenirs and gifts available there. As you'll see in the water, just imagine they've been on board a small vessel, abandoned ship, the ship has sunk, or the boat has sunk. Been able to light a flare to attract the attention of the lifeboat. The lifeboat now have sight of the casualty in the water. Imagine all being all by yourself in the water and seeing that lifeboat coming towards you, taking you home to your wife and kids. Public donations and subscriptions, legacies, enable the RNLI to continue their good works 365 days of the year. Now approaching the casualty. You see how... Ladies and gentlemen, a nice round of applause and a big cheer for the volunteer crew members of the all-weather lifeboat, the William F. Yates, and the inshore rescue boat, the Barbara, Dr. Barbara Saunderson. Come on, everybody, put your hands together for them now. Thanks for your service, guys. Great show today. Thank you.
Yeah.
on YouTube and watch the training of what you're about to see. And it was quite phenomenal to see how fast this boat can get beached, almost ending up on the road. Turning around, ready to sail directly towards us at speed. Get ready. All crew members will be strapped into the seats. Here we go. £2.25 million of Shannon class lifeboat. Ladies and gentlemen, the William F. Yates. Thank you.